Hey, it's me, GV, and welcome back to Let's Play The Elder Scrolls V Skyrim. Ladies and gentlemen, let me pull my mic back just a little bit further. My face is a little too close to the screen, and when that happens, well, can't quite concentrate on what I'm saying because all I see is the game, literally, encompassing my entire field of view. You might be asking yourself, Vaughn, why are you in some random cave? This is actually not some random cave. This is Snowvale Sanctum, where we most recently were betrayed by Mercer Frey. The reason I am here is because I decided to do some grinding. I believe I got my illusion all the way to 100, and my conjuration up to around 80, I think. Conjuration takes a bit longer to grind out. Basically, what I did was I went back to Snowvale Sanctum. I found this Draugr right here. I had Illusion in my right hand, Muffle in my right hand, which powers up Illusion, and Soul Trap in my left hand, which powers up Conjuration. And I just alternated casting like this. And I did that until I had 100 in Illusion, like I said, around 80 in Conjuration. You might ask yourself, well, this is a PC Let's Play. And some people are probably even like, what? This is a PC Let's Play. I've seen, you know, press A to search the urn. This is not on Xbox 360. No, my friends. Come on. You think you get this frame rate on Xbox 360? So you might be asking yourself, why didn't you just, you know, go into the console and do it that way? Well, because I have not activated the console one time in this entire LP. I never activate the console at all unless, like, there's nothing that I can do. I'm stuck somewhere and I don't want to... I've been walking for an hour and I don't want to, you know, reload a save or something. And I haven't. In this Let's Play, that has not happened. I have not done anything with the console the entire time. And I don't do exploits. It just ruins the fun. So, yes, I grinded it out while listening to PKA. Yes, it took a while, but we made it work. And so here's what we're going to do. We have a bunch of level ups now. A bunch of level ups. I'm not sure how many, but it's probably going to be around at least 5, I would imagine. Now, the problem is I'm not sure exactly. I feel like 300 health would be a good target. So I guess we'll just... Okay, let's just jump into this. The problem is once you've gone into the level up menu, you're locked into it. You have to apply the points, which I hate. I think that's a terrible thing, and even if we press B, it just scrolls through these for some reason. Let me go back out. What if I have a change of heart? I don't know. So either way, we're going to put points into hell. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, now we have 300 health, 150 stamina, and around 300 magicka. Here's the thing. We can eventually get enchantment to where all of our magicka costs 0. We can just constantly spam it. That's a thing that can happen. So I have to ask myself, is it better to put points into magicka or better to put points into health at this point? Maybe even stamina, and everything is increased by 30 anyways because we have the Galdur amulet. I was going to not even level up in the Let's Play because I wanted to think about this more before I started recording, but I sort of just jumped into it. I think maybe we'll get magicka up to 400 because we could still have some magic. Yeah, you know what? Or maybe stamina. You know what? Let's just put stamina up to 200. We're not really vying for too much here in any area, magicka, health, or stamina. So I think, okay, well, we have 6 level ups. So yeah, I think we'll get stamina up to 200. We'll keep health at 300. And then maybe I'll do some research either after this episode or the next and figure out where I want to put those points. So we recently also leveled up Destruction to 60, which I didn't realize, which means we might have another perk on our hands here. Maybe not, though. Fire spells do 50% more damage. Well, hell yeah. That's what we're definitely going to put 1 point into that. We also have 5 more perks, and we can perk points. We can increase, or we can put them into lockpick, because I've been complaining about that a lot. But let's take a look at Illusion, because obviously we have 100 now. Illusion spells work on the Undead, Daedra, and Automatons. Pretty crappy. Don't really need that, honestly. Let's see what else we have. Calm spells. Okay, let's take a look at the top for each of these. Cast Master level Illusion spells for half magicka. I'm not even sure if we have any Illusion spells that we can upgrade. We're also going to visit the College of Winterhold, either before or after talking to Carlyle. Probably after. So, maybe we just hold the perk points and then see what we can buy. I'm thinking that's the smart idea. Also, of course, we can level up Conjuration, which is now, what? 83. Okay. Let's see. What do we got over here? Yeah, we want twin souls. So we're probably definitely going to go down this line. Okay, that's kind of good. Yeah, let's get Atromancy. Double duration for Conjured Atronax. Conjured Atronax are 50% more powerful. And we want to save the rest for either Illusion. And then we definitely want to save one for Twin Souls. Okay, now let's take a look at our quest here. Before intercepting Mercer Frey, Carlia wishes to speak to both Brynjolf and myself. I exited the Thieves Guild before I finished talking with her, because obviously you guys want to see that exchange. And I wanted to grind a bit. I was actually going to get Illusion and Conjuration both up to 100, but figured what's the point in that? Illusion is one thing because it's pretty utility-based. You know, we're not really using Illusion to increase our damage output. We're using it to sneak around and do certain weird things. Whereas Conjuration, you know, we're actually killing people with it. So if it's already at 100, there's no point unless we're making it legendary, which we're probably not going to be. Anyways, let's talk to Carlia.
Brynjolf, the time has come to decide Mercer's fate. Until a new guildmaster is chosen, the decision falls to you.
Aye, lass. And I've come to a decision.
Mercer Frey tried to kill both of you. He betrayed the guild, murdered Gallus, and made us question our future. He needs to die.
We have to be very careful, Brynjolf. Mercer is a nightingale, an agent of Nocturnal.
And it's all true. Everything I heard in the stories. The Nightingales, their allegiance to Nocturnal and the Twilight Sepulchre.
That's why we need to prepare ourselves and meet Mercer on equal footing. Just outside of Riften, beyond the southeast gate, is a small path cut up the mountainside. At the end of that path is a clearing and an old standing stone. I'd ask you both to meet me there.
I have some preparations of my own to make. I'll meet you at the stone.
Alrighty. So before we do that, once again, we're going to go back to the College of Winterhold, because now, of course, we can have access to the Master Illusion spell. Actually, I'm not sure how that goes. I do know that as far as destruction goes, again, first time playing a mage, I feel like I always have to remind people of that because they think of me as like the Skyrim master. No, I played Skyrim for fun. I've never really concerned myself with researching everything there is to know about a game. That's not the type of, you know, play style that I play. But yes, I do know that as far as destruction goes, there are people you have to get the master level destruction spells from, and even then, they're just giant AoE crazy bomb spells, right? I'm not sure if that's the case for the other trees. I feel like it's not, but we'll find out. I'm pretty sure everyone's supposed to be in here, right? Oh, and also I've recently heard of a tip where if we wait past a certain time, I forget, it might be 8, everybody appears in their respective rooms. You can see we have Tolfdir here. Okay, I think I went into the wrong room, though, because, yes, this is going to be all of the apprentices and Tolfdir who does alteration, which we have not increased just yet. One of the other things that I forgot to say is that I have looked up how to grind out all of the respective magic trees. For the most part, we've done the easy ones, Illusion and Conjuration. The other ones take a little bit more, like constantly casting destruction on Shadowmere and stuff. Okay, so Feralda is destruction, which we don't really have any upgrades available to us just yet.
I wonder what we could have done with the eye, had it been put to better use.
Okay, so this is the guy that sells illusion magic, and we have, I think, a new dialogue option here. What else is there to be learned about illusion magic?
You have gone beyond my teachings, which is quite a feat. I did not think it possible, but there is always more to learn. I believe you are ready for the next step.
What's the next step?
Knowledge of truly powerful illusion spells is here at the college, but it is hidden from those who might misuse it. I shall teach you a spell to discern things hidden from others. With it, you will be able to acquire the texts you need. Bring all 4 to me, and I shall use them to inscribe the spells for you.
Okay, this is very, very, very interesting to me. I really 100% thought that that the master level spell quests only applied to destruction, and that's really the only quests I've never done, simply because I've never played mages, and I didn't really want to grind out all the points to complete all of those. So I guess I haven't really done a full completionist playthrough, although I don't know. I could have. I guess I was just so done by the time I completed everything else in Skyrim that I really didn't want to grind out all of the magic points, and that's not really fun for me anyways, just grinding out points. But regardless, we've gotten a quest here, Illusion Ritual Spell. Drevis Nelerin has told me that there are books hidden throughout the College of Winterhold that contain information about powerful illusion spells. I need to use the spells he's given me. The spell he's given me, Vision of the Tenth Eye, to find them. Bring the Four Master Illusion Text to Drevis Nelerin. And again, this is just crazy to me right now because I don't even know if I've ever read about this. I've only read about the destruction ones. So I guess he's already put that spell into my knowledge, I guess you could call it, which has to be illusion, of course, right? Here we have Vision of the Tenth Eye. See what others cannot, and it costs zero and is a magic, or is a novice level spell. Also, it automatically equips it in both hands, and it does the big animation as if we were doing a big spell. Okay, so I am not sure what to do with this. Obviously we have to find four books, but we have no quest markers. And again, I have not heard about this spell whatsoever. We've got around four locations to explore, don't we? We've got the Hall of the Elements, the two other halls, and then the Arcanium and the Archmage Quarters. So I'm going to assume there's going to be one book in like each one. Maybe they're just all in the Arcanium. That would make the most sense, wouldn't it? Now, it sort of seems that we have like a cat's eye effect, and I was going to say, I'm not sure when it's going to leave us.
Are one of the few things that keep us in touch with the rest of Sky.
And from what I've heard, this is the problem with the master level destruction spells as well, is that you have to do this big animation, you know, and by that time, you're either interrupted or taking too much damage or whatever. Oh, why does it do this every time? It's so stupid. Okay, we're in the... Wait a second. Oh, we are in the Arcanium now. Okay, so I'm really not sure at all what we need to do here. Like I've been saying, I'm not sure if things are going to glow or what. Maybe
I'm not
Urag has something to say.
My rules about books.
Yeah,
no.
And it wears off pretty fast.
Might have been lost were it not for you.
So I'm going to look for a little bit and see if anything stands out to me. I would really feel like one of them at least is going to be in the Arcanium, but so far, nothing is standing out. I'm really surprised they didn't give us more hints. Huh. Okay. Well, let's take a look.
With that Ancano fellow.
Let's take a look one more at the quest. There are books hidden throughout the College of Winterhold that contain information about powerful illusion
spells.
That
I was unable to assist,
yeah.
But I was...
All right, I'm just going to go ahead and look online because I literally have no clue where to start with this. Actually, you know what? Maybe we'll just explore the Archmage's Quarters and see if we can find any in there before giving up. I just don't want to go on a wild goose chase for half the episode. So let's activate this once more. See if we can find anything standing out to us. If they're not in the Arcanium, where the hell would they be, you know? And I'm not sure if we have to activate bookshelves too or something. Just don't know. Any hidden books? The rolls of paper glow a little bit, but of course they're just rolls of paper, nothing unique. Alright, well, let me go ahead and figure this out, ladies and gents, and I'll see you in a second. Okay, I've looked up the four locations, and I'm glad that... And I'm glad that I did, because we've already been to the Arcanium, of course, and one of them actually is in the Arcanium, and I didn't see it. One of them's in the Midden, and I don't think I would have looked there unless I looked it up.
There are
and the other two are in the respective halls to the east and to the west or whatever. So we're going to go ahead and activate this. I'm pretty sure it has to be active. And apparently, the first one is over here to the left somewhere, like maybe underneath a chair, or I think it said somewhere around this table. Oh, Master Illusion Text. Okay, I think I walked right past it then. Okay, so let's read this. Illusion's pretty cool. Once you become an illusion master, you can do all sorts of things. Some things naughty, but, you know, try not to do that stuff too often. And have fun, dudes. And then dudes is spelled with a Z. I'm not sure if you guys can read that text there, but you know, I've played my fair share of Skyrim and the Elder Scrolls, so it's not as difficult for me to decipher it. Alright, so, like I said, the other two are going to be in the Hall of Countenance. the Hall of whatever the other one is, and then the last one's going to be in the Midden, I think, by the Atronach Forge. So let's start with the left one over here. I always forget what they're named. This one is the Hall of Countenance. Okay. And I happen to know that this one is upstairs as well. I could have, of course, just found out what area they're in and then try to find it myself. But that's not, again, that's not really how I play video games either. If there's something that I have to find and there's no quest markers, for instance, the Stones of Baron Zaya, you bet your ass I am not actually finding all of those one by one, taking 10 years. No way, Jose. That's not how I do things. Okay, so one of the books should be in this hall. I know it's on the second floor, and I'm not sure exactly where it is other than that. It's got to be in one of these rooms. We're just looking for a book that looks identical to the other one, I would imagine, right? And it's annoying having to constantly cast this spell. I mean, it's not that great of a spell that we need to do this giant animation for. You know what I mean? And I'm not even sure if this spell has any other uses other than this quest. That'd be really cool because, again, I've just never heard of this. Okay, where is it? Come on. Don't make me look at the resource again. Just show me where it is. Okay, well, we're running out of rooms here. This is the last one. Come on, everybody cross your fingers. And okay, it's glitched a bit. And as you can see, we do actually need to have this active. Wished it lasted a little longer. Hopefully this being glitched like this doesn't matter too much. Okay, I've already used that joke once and I'm not going to extend it because it's just going to show how bad I am at improvising jokes. The first one wasn't even that good. Don't stand there all creepy, dude. That's super creepy. We've got two more illusion books to find, and I don't even know what we're going to get from the master. I don't even know what we're going to get from completing the quest. I'm actually, like, just super excited to figure that out. I don't know what it could be. I would, like, invisibility sounds like the most powerful spell to me, you know? What else is better than that in terms of illusion? Maybe just like an AoE fury or calm spell or something like that.
Did Delvin send you again, or are you here on your own this time?
Don't worry about it, my friend. Okay, so I know the other book is in one of these rooms as well, but again, I'm not sure which one. But it seems to be not hidden too much. It's just hidden in plain sight, you know what I mean? So, on one of these barrels again? No? Trying to find it before a thing runs out. Hay bales? Maybe under a bed or something? So far, they've just been on top of things, so I don't think they'd be under a bed. No. Okay. I don't think it would be in a bedroom either. Oh no, we weren't able to find this one. I seem to remember it saying that it was under something, maybe.
Send you again, or are you here on your own this time?
Okay, let me consult the guide. Okay, so check this out. If this is indeed the Hall of Attainment, which I think it is, because the main one is the Hall of the Element, and this guy keeps talking, get away from me, please. I've got books to find. It should be, yeah, right here. Look at this. Okay. There we go. Wonderful. We've got one more book to find, and this one should be easier than the others. Well, not really. Is the entrance to the Midden in this one? Nope, I guess it's in the other one. Unfortunate, but it's also just outside as well. Yeah, like I said, the final book is going to be near the Midden. Inside of the Midden, I should say. There was an entrance over here, right? A hatch in the floor. Yes. Not sure if we wanted to go into the other one or what. It doesn't really matter too much. We just need to find the Atronach Forge. And I don't remember exactly where that is, but it shouldn't be too difficult to find. There's not too much to find in the Midden other than that and the miscellaneous quest. So if we just run into a direction... There we go. Alright, so it should be somewhere around here. Again, I'm not sure exactly where. Maybe on the table? Oh, look, it's that easy. And there is the final illusion book. Why is my quest not updating? Bring the four master illusion texts to the... Wait a second. Oh my god. Did we just not have that activated? Would it have told me where they were? I mean, that seems in the vein of Skyrim to just tell me where they are instead of having us actually find them. I'm not really sure, but it looks like we didn't have them activated. Okay, we don't want to go into the mid and dark. How the hell do I get back up? Oh well, you guys aren't really going to see too much wasted time because I've cut when I was trying to find the things, but still. Jeez. Okay. Well, we're human because we make mistakes. Alright, let's get the hell out of here and see what our reward is going to be. That's so interesting. That's really interesting. I wonder if all of the quests are like that then. Restoration, alteration, just finding texts. I'm not sure. But...
The Eye of Magnus. Here, but lost. Slipped through our grasp. Oh, what we might have learned.
Here are the texts you requested.
Yes, very good. Here then is the first of the illusion spells you sought.
Hysteria? The first? Excuse me? What?
All right then.
The first of the illusion spells we sought? And it's already... Oh no, there it is. Creatures and people up to level 25 flee from combat for 60 seconds. Okay. Is that it?
I wonder what we could have done with the eye. Oh my, that's quite...
Never underestimate... They can turn the... There are also spells that help in avoiding conflict altogether.
Huh.
So, you wish to master the arcane...
Well, that's extremely... after we talk to Drevis and see if he... You know what? No, I'm going to do it right now. I'm going to go ahead and take a look online and see if that's really the only spell that we get. Okay, this is extremely weird. So basically how this happens is he gives you one of the books for free, but if we go into his books, he's got the other three in his inventory that we have to actually buy. One of them is Call to Arms. Targets have improved combat skills, health, and stamina for 10 minutes. So I don't know what the point of that would be other than to grind out quests and I guess to buff up your allies? Yeah, but that's not worth 3,000 gold. No way, Jose. Another one was Harmony. Creatures and people up to level 25 nearby won't fight for 60 seconds. And the other one is Mayhem. The last one is Mayhem. Creatures and people up to level 25 will attack anyone nearby for 60 seconds. So this is really the only one that seems interesting. Creatures and people up to level 25 will attack anyone nearby. Yeah, we're going to buy that one. The other two I don't think I would ever use. And the one that we got for free, I'm already forgetting what it was. But we will take that. We will take that indeed. And I guess there's not really another point to look at anything else because we've already got the master level spells for each one, right? They're basically just upgrades of all the stuff that we've already had or have, other than invisibility, of course. Yeah, so I think we're done with illusion for now. But let's go into items and books and mayhem. And we'll activate that, and we'll also go into magic, illusion, mayhem, and favorite it. And we'll have to look for situations... You know what? There's probably going to be one very, very close to where we're at, where we are at right now, where we'll be able to use this. And just to give you guys a hint of what I'm talking about, I was thinking when there's a lot of Falmer around, you know, we activate that and they all just attack each other. So we'll just have to remember to utilize that one. The other thing that I wanted to look up was Conjuration, which Finis Gestor does sell.
There are few places where one can pursue my type of work without fear of... So, you wish to master the arcane arts.
Okay, so we should be able to buy some decent upgrades here. Banish Daedra, I think, was the upgrade to Soul Tear or Soul Trap in terms of grinding out Conjuration. You can use Banish Daedra, or it might just be Banish anything, because actually, Weaker Summon Daedra, yeah, that sounds difficult to find. There was a Banish spell that you could upgrade after using Soul Trap to grind out Conjuration. But that's fine. We're already pretty high on Conjuration anyways. Let's see. So Bound Battle Axe, Bound Bow, and Bound Sword. Those are the three weapons we have available to us. Let's just... Yeah. So the question we have to ask ourselves, do we want to stick with Battle Axe or do we want to go to Bow or Sword? I feel like Sword would be the best, although Bow is by far the most expensive. And also, we didn't have access to it before, which makes me think that... I'm just imagining myself close to the enemies like we've been normally, and I don't think... Although, if we're conjuring Atronachs, maybe we conjure the Atronach and then switch to the bow, and then we just hit them from afar. That sounds actually good, especially with the Conjure Atronachs Far Away perk. Okay, so we'll get bow. Creates a magic bow for 120 seconds, sheath it to this spell. Let's see. Command Daedra. Powerful summoned and raised creatures are put under your control. That's okay. Ooh, Dremora Lord. Now that I like. Familiar, Flame, Frost, and Storm Atronach. Storm Atronach are pretty cool. Okay, so this is the most expensive one so far. Dread Zombie. Reanimate a very powerful dead body. Yeah, that sucks. Okay. So I think what we're going to get is Conjure Dremora Lord. Yeah. And we spent quite a lot of money on these spells, so we'll have to make sure to utilize them. Bound Bow. Conjure Dremora Lore. I don't think we have any other spells. No. So, let's go into magic. Let's go into favorites. And unfavorite everything we're not going to use, such as Bound Battle Axe. I went through my favorites recently, so all of the stuff that I have is pretty much what we want, except for the conjuration stuff. So, goodbye. And I think everything else is good. Muffle Invisibility we'll keep, because obviously we're still doing the Thieves Guild. And Soul Trap I think will take off as well, because I'm probably not going to be doing any more grinding. Okay, and now let's go into Conjuration and Favorite Bound Bow, and put that in our right hand, and Favorite Conjure Dremora Lord, and put that in our left. And now we're pretty powerful at Conjuration. So this entire episode, as you guys can probably tell, has pretty much just been setting everything up, and also, of course, completing the illusion.
May I just say it's a pleasure to have you leading the college, really.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Yeah, completing the illusions quest, and we're probably going to be doing that for every magic skill tree. Anyways, let's go ahead and do this quest now. Meet Carlia at the Standing Stone, which should be somewhat outside of Riften. Indeed it is. But we've got a little bit to go here. Do we want to go to the stables and cross around? I think so. So yeah, my mind's still a little bit blown here that there's a master level quest for each skill tree. I would imagine Restoration is just going to be, you know, the ultimate form of healing yourself. Alteration, I'm really not sure. It's probably going to be a multiple thing, just like... Yeah, I seem to remember Riften was actually surrounded by water, so I don't think Shadowmere is going to help us out too much. I'm going to start swimming my way over here as I talk. Yeah, I would imagine Restoration is going to be the ultimate form of healing ourselves. Maybe it's the same for all of the lesser things, unlike Destruction, which obviously is going to give us access to the best Destruction spells, and there's really only three types of Destruction magic anyways. Frost, Fire, and Electricity. Or Shocks, I should say. Whatever. However you want to say it. Whereas all the other stuff, you know, we've got the best ward for... ward's alteration, though, isn't it? Because Tolftir teaches it to us. I always forget if wards are alteration or restoration. But you guys see where I'm going along with this line of thinking here. We're going to get pretty close. We're not going to initiate conversation. We're going to end the episode. So they're probably going to be right ahead. Yeah, I can already see them. Thank you so much for watching this episode, ladies and gentlemen. I know it was sort of a different paced one, a little different in that, you know, like I said, we're just setting everything up and completing some stuff and buying some upgrades. But next episode should be pretty interesting indeed, considering our new stuff, Bound Bow and Dremora Lord, which I always love summoning Dremoras. That was actually one of my first early on Oblivion playthroughs. Oh, and look at this. We've got a dragon. Well... let's go ahead and end the episode with that then. Test out all this stuff, shall we? Put that away. Brynjolf, if you guys want to help, I'm not sure. I'm not even sure what this Dremora Lord is going to be able to do. But it's good that we got a bound bow at least. Luckily, I don't think... oh, this is just a base level dragon anyway. So actually, this should go pretty fast. Just don't want Brynjolf and Carlia to start talking to me, since they're going to be dragged over to me now. The Dremora Lord, I don't think he's going to be able to do anything. And where did he even go? I don't know. Dragon, if you could go ahead and thank you very much. All right, Dremora Lord, now's your time to shine, buddy. Okay, yeah, pretty easy. Now, Brynjolf, go back to where you were, my friend. Don't come near me, please. All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for watching. I'm going to absorb this dragon soul and end the episode. In the next episode, like I said, we'll try out all of this stuff. And look at this guy. Pretty cool, right? Way better than a Flame Atronach. Thanks for watching again, and I will see you guys there. Bye-bye.